The warm spring sunlight shines down on me. A refreshing breeze blows past. I have plenty of leeway to make it to school on time. If I keep walking at this pace, there's no way I'll be late. It's not that I believe Fujibayashi's fortune from yesterday. However, just to be safe, I'm walking to school earlier than usual. But then again, to other students, this might already count as being a bit late. There aren't that many people wearing school uniforms along this road anymore. In any case, it's still early enough for me to get to school on time. Now, according to Fujibayashi's fortune, there should be an old lady having trouble crossing the street. And I'll be late if I were to help her. To begin with, there isn't an old lady at this crosswalk. I glance just beyond the white lines, painted like a ladder on the asphalt. I don't like this. Where I'm looking, there's an old lady holding onto a utility pole with her hip stooped. She keeps glancing left and right. No matter how I look at it, something is wrong. All the other students feign ignorance and simply walk past her. And our eyes meet. Perhaps it's just me, but I feel like she's staring at me. It almost feels like she's silently saying, "You can't even lend a helping hand when others are in trouble?" If I give in to those eyes, will Fujibayashi's fortune come true? Talk! I would really love to pretend I didn't see her, but I can't just leave her be when she's looking at me like that. I guess I am more of a busybody than I thought. I let out a sigh and walked to the crosswalk. "Hey, Matt!" She suddenly screams at me. "You're trying to cross the street, aren't you?" She keeps yelling at me as she steps backward. "Like I was saying, are you..." Say something that makes sense! Oh my god, I should have ignored her. Fine, you old hag. Oh my god! I should have f***ing left her be. Sorry. Well, that's strange. For once, I'm trying to do something nice and everybody here is vilifying me for it. As my attention shifts to the rubberneckers, the old lady suddenly moves. She takes a step back, straightens her bent back, and quickly reaches for the ground? Right where her foot was, there's something shining. A 500 yen coin? In the blink of an eye, she snatches it off the ground and runs off at a speed that would put younger people to shame. Hey! Don't tell me she was looking around because she was waiting to pick up the 500 yen coin. And did she yell at me so that I wouldn't take her 500 yen? Oh my god! What the hell are you staring at, huh? The onlookers scramble away like baby spiders. Jeez, what's with this morning? I'll be thanked and get some money for my trouble? Fujibayashi's fortune was a sham! Hell, I'm an idiot for believing it for even a second. Should have left her be. It's been a while since I've attended homeroom. I say attend, but all I really did was sit there in the classroom. I don't remember a thing the teacher said. The bell ring and ends homeroom. The homeroom teacher walks out of the room. It's now the short recess before first period. Rather than preparing for the lesson, I space out. What now, Fujibayashi? Fujibayashi looks at me with her timid looking eyes. Yeah, your fortune was off. Thank goodness? Shouldn't you be disappointed? But your fortune was off. Huh? Is that so? Having said so, Fujibayashi pulls her deck of cards out of her pocket again. Shuffle. Looks like she's telling my fortune once again. Shuffle. Yes. Clatter. And they fall all over the floor again. However, unlike yesterday, she does not immediately pick up the cards. She stares at them on the floor. What? What? Hold on. You're telling me that just by looking at the cards on the floor? I didn't even get to pick any cards this time. Okay. What do you mean, you think? Aside, didn't you go, when you dropped the cards? Come on. Yeah, right. Some secret chant that was. Well, fine. So, what's my fortune? The hell is that? I don't get it. A maiden's intuition again? So, what's that lovely encounter about? Fujibayashi points at a single card. It's the Queen of Spades. I met her Monday. Gentle? A sword. If I had to choose, I'd say that means aggressive. Wouldn't that make her a dangerous person instead? Will today's fortune come true? That's not an answer, honey. That sure is a vague response. I'm getting bamboozled. Fujibayashi, you did me dirty. I'm tired. Me too, Tomoya. It's been a long time since I've attended first period. And just like homeroom, I don't remember a single thing that was said. On top of that, I feel terrible as everything is putting me to sleep. Should I sleep through second period, or should I just leave the classroom and ditch? I mean, if you're gonna sleep... Who are you? Oh, is it the other Fujibayashi? Just as I was zoning out, I hear a familiar voice from above my head. This voice is...
Yep.
Hi, Kyo. Can you tell Ryo to stop doing my fortune? Kyo! I see a familiar face. You're not saying you know her name. Oh, I just read it's Ryo Fujibayashi and I was like, didn't you just say it was Kyo? Anyway, it's Ryo Fujibayashi's twin sister, Kyo Fujibayashi. Even though I'm branded as a delinquent, she's one of the few students who doesn't mind talking to me. She's part of another class. Why are you here? You have really good theme music as well. She shows me what seems to be a lunchbox, wrapped in a napkin with a floral pattern. You giving me that? You're blushing. That's true. I would find it perplexing if she suddenly gave me one for no reason. Rather, it would make me wonder if she had poisoned it. Poisoned it, huh? Yes. This is just your imagination.
Ryo!
Okay, so that's how you say it. As Fujibayashi walks toward us, Kyo swings the lunchbox she's holding in her hand, and probably hits me in the head. And it goes flying everywhere. So, Ryo is an airhead. Why are you handing it to her now of all times? Like, the two of you live together, why are you handing her the lunchbox now? Don't you two come to school together? Wake her up! You're too soft. Sounds like bragging to me. Does she throw a fit? That's creepy. Huh? But you weren't late now, were you? Oh, so you two took different buses. So only you were late, huh? Okay. Come on. Not sure how that works. I'm kinda curious. She woke up late but came on time. Like, did she... She probably biked or something. Yeah. I wanna know this. Did you run? Okay. Vague! Why does no one answer your question like a normal person here? Best? I shouldn't have pressed because now it's just like, oh, it's an inside thing and we're gonna keep it vague and it's only the two of us who understand it. Hee hee! You did something bad, didn't you?
But...
Oh yeah, she has a scooter, doesn't she? Hit someone? I mean, if you can't drive it, don't drive it. It kind of feels like she just inadvertently said something pretty scary. Are you hiding something? He's saying you have secrets. That means you are hiding something. I'm pretty sure she has a scooter, and she has no idea how to drive it. What do you mean? I'm here because I got bullied by an old lady. Because of your sister. I don't know. That's awfully rude. Yeah. I'm sorry for coming to school on time. I mean, sometimes I just wake up. Sometimes I just wake up. You know, most times I don't, but sometimes I do. I got here in time. What else? She froze. Yeah. Okay. Yeah, Kyo, I'm kidding. I'm not here on time. I'm actually- you're imagining me being here right now. This is your imagination. I'm a hologram. So, like... yeah. Is that rare for me? Is it that rare for me to be here on time? Yes. Jeez. Oh? Guess my presence transcends even supernatural phenomena. Yes, I sleep on the school grounds. What? Oh, please say yes. Oh, you're so boring. Oh my god, you need to prank them. Like the hell I did. Yes. I'm actually a clone. Nope. Where's the real one then? I let out a sigh and glanced at the sky. I fought my fate today. Kyo looks a little worried and places her hand on my forehead. Why is everyone just touching everyone? I don't have a fever. Hmm? Don't give me that pitying look. Don't mock me. Leave me alone. Wouldn't you normally ask, what fate? Yes. Ryo, this is actually all your fault. Yeah, that's right. No, that's why she brought it up. Yeah. After my response, Kyo looks at me with a weird expression on her face. What's with that look? You look really creepy. Mm-hmm. Just say it. Jeez, Kyo, your sister is such a bird brain. Ouch! Didn't you hit me because you hurt me? Yeah, Kyo, do I need to tell you twice? But you know, birds are super intelligent, so is that really an insult? Yep, that's it. No, it's not you. Again? Why are you looking at me like that? As she takes a breath, Kyo shakes her head and lays her hand on my shoulder. She then nuts. Her eyes conceal a hint of pity. Seem awfully happy about that. She says, and then leaves the classroom. What's that supposed to mean? Fujibayashi and I were left to puzzle over this mystery during the short time before the next bell. Second period begins. I drift off, lost in my own thoughts as the teacher drones on in the background. How much do you sleep? Come on. Oh my god, click. I think of that girl from yesterday, my own past. Should learn more about... I want to learn more about Tomoya. These girls, man. My own past. I can't recall stuff from a long time ago. And the more recent things that I can, well, I'd rather not remember at all. Oh, what a waste of time then. Those memories are all stained with disappointment. I continue resting my chin on my hands, still looking out the window. Stay like this until class ends. Well, that didn't give me anything.
Yawn. Me too.
With no plans to go to college after graduating, nothing feels more meaningless to me right now than sitting through class.
Then go home.
Tsunohara isn't here either. I'm bored. My mind continues tuning out the teacher's words. The same subject may change here and there, but it's all the same to me, really.
Yeah, skip.
If you're so unhappy, skip. Don't come. Don't complain. I leave the classroom and head over to the old building. I tiptoe my way down the hallway. It's not suspicious at all. Most of the classrooms here aren't used anymore. They'd give a culture club one of these rooms if they applied for it, but for now, they're just being left as is. I sneak into one of the empty classrooms unnoticed. I find a chair and sit down, placing my whole weight on it. Beyond the curtainless windows, I see the same sky as always. I go to the trouble of being truant, and all I do is kill time. The air of the empty room absorbs my muttering. When will my life change? Will there come a day when it will change? Someone I knew said that once. That guy must be really effeminate, I think to myself. Then I realize I was the one who said it. Close my eyes. How great things would be if you could fast forward time. Feeling the unrelenting sun on my face, I open my eyes. I've had enough of being in an empty room. I get up and leave the classroom.
So productive!
I aimlessly walk down the stairs. A sliding door down the hallway catches my eye. It's the library. A sign that reads, "Closed," hangs from the door. Upon closer inspection, the door is slightly ajar. It grabs my attention, though I couldn't say why.
It says closed, but the door is open. Of course it catches your attention.
I open the door and step inside. Tall bookshelves and reading tables line the room. A faint breeze carries the fragrance of dust and paper. The curtains flow and flutter as if they're breathing. Beyond that, I see a silhouette. It's a quiet female student wearing a childish hair ornament. The emblem on her chest shows that she's a third year, like me. For some reason, she's sitting on the floor. Maybe she feels sick. I walk closer and notice that she's immersed in a book. Is she playing hooky too? Sunuhara and I are the only ones who'd be outside the classroom at this time of the day. She doesn't notice me and continues reading. But then, she suddenly stops turning the pages. She found something. She takes out a pair of scissors. She positions the blade on a page and stops for a few seconds. It's almost as if she's meditating. And then, snip, snip, snip. She cuts through the book without any more hesitation. Hey, wait! I love this theme so much, actually. I run up to her without thinking. Hey. She stops and looks at my face. She's barefoot for some reason. Her campus shoes and socks lay on the floor. Surrounding her is a mountain of books and a bag that probably belongs to her. Now that I look more closely, there's even a cushion that she brought from somewhere. Her glare and the relaxed way she's sitting make everything seem unbalanced. That book belongs to the library. She's thinking of something. Snip, snip, snip.
Hi.
She cuts off the corner of the page she extracted from the book and hands it to me. What? She's talking about the paper like it's a slice of cake or meat. You eat this? I accept the piece of paper, but I hold it up and question her. Okay. I thought so. No. I don't want to eat it either. I'm starting to get hungry. We're making conversation, but nothing seems to make sense. Anyway, I don't think it's good to cut up the school's books. It's out of character for me, but I lecture her. You're lecturing a lot of people these days. You lectured Nakisa, now you're lecturing... Is it Kotomi her name is? Snip snip. She's not listening. Huh? Never mind. Do what you want. I drop the piece of paper she gave me on the floor. Since I'm here anyway, I glance at the books around her. The thickest book says Astrophysics, From Past to Future, on the cover. It's one of those books where I wouldn't understand a single word. These books seem too specialized and expensive for a library like this. Looking more closely at the one she's holding, it's stamped Property of Prefectural Library. It isn't the school's book after all. Hey... I scratch my head. Didn't your parents ever tell you to take care of public property? She's deep in thought again. She takes a box from her bag and pops open the lid. Yes, I can see that. It looks really good though. I'm in such a bad mood since the old lady incident. I'll try to be a bit more positive. Yes. I didn't ask.
ほうれん草と煮豆なの。
Okay.
Good
for you. She points at the contents of the container. It does look good. If I remember correctly, no food or drink is allowed in the library. Never mind that, we should be in class right now. Yes. Look here. You make lunch of clay? You usually eat lunches made of clay? I don't want to eat clay either.
You already asked me this.
I'm starting to get hungry. I mean, you have a lunch, so go ahead. Our conversation isn't going anywhere, and almost seems to be repeating itself. Hold on, I'm... She looks straight into my eyes and asks me again. There's a hint of loneliness in her voice. The breeze from the window floats across her childish hair ornament. It makes me feel guilty for some reason. Sure. I'll take a little. She nods with a sigh of relief. Yes. She puts her hands together and bows. You're gonna feed me? Okay. Hey, I can't do this. It's embarrassing, and we just met. She doesn't seem to understand what's embarrassing about it. Jeez. The way this girl is acting is unworldly. Eat with your fingers. Or I could eat with my fingers. I pluck a piece of the stew and toss it into my mouth. Yeah, there you go. I chew thoroughly. It's cold, but well seasoned. Considering this is handmade, I think she's a great cook. She's about to say something as she looks at my face again. It's okay. She smiles faintly. I hear the lunch bell ring. In 15 minutes, this place will be crowded with students trying to study. She doesn't have much in that box anyway. I can't bring myself to take more. Sorry I bothered you. After saying that, I turn my back to her. I know she's hesitant about saying something. That's bold of you to assume that I'll be coming again tomorrow. That's all I hear. I raise my left hand in answer before leaving the library.
Okazaki, oh.
Hello, Sunohara, where did you come from? Don't say that like you've been at school all this time. You just got here, right? Okay. What a wonderful school experience you must be having. You're no different from a patch of mold that lives in that dorm. You know that, right? Well, yeah, it's lunch time. What did you expect? I notice a girl standing quietly by the entrance of the cafeteria. She's completely still, waiting for the chaos to subside. If you just stand there, all that will be left is anpan. Hey, Sunohara.
Huh? Pan ni suru no?
Just take your time here and eat.
What?
I buy a 180 yen ticket for plain udon from the machine and shove it towards Sunohara.
Ogori! Lucky!
Lucky!
Something came up that I have to take care of. I could make friends with the rugby team or something.
Rugby部とは食わない!
But they love you!
つうか、お前の用って何?
It's a stomach ache or a headache. Can't you figure that much out on your own?
そりゃ大変だな。お大事に。
I will.
じゃあね。
See you! Yeah. Sunohara stands in line at the counter. I should bill him for that later. I make sure he's lost in the crowd and out of sight before going over to the girl. Despite standing right in front of her, she doesn't notice me. Because she's an airhead! A lot of these girls are kind of like, we're airheads. Ish. It's as though she could never imagine meeting an acquaintance in a place like this. Hey! She takes several steps back in surprise.
Okazaki-san! Okazaki-san mo irashitan desu ne?
Yeah.
Pan desu ka?
Yeah.
So desu ka. Pan totemo ii to omoimasu.
What about you?
Watashi desu ka?
It somehow feels like she's forcing herself to act cheerful. Like she wants to show off her good side even to someone like me.
Watashi wa sono... Kyou wa anpan igai no mono wo katte miyou ka to omottan desu ga...
She looks at the crowd of students.
Yappari... muri mitai desu.
Just push your way through! Do you even try to get one?
Hai... Ichiban hayaku kyoushitsu wo demashita.
Wow.
Demo... Jugyou ga owaru no ga osokatta
mono de... Yeah, I wouldn't expect a girl to be able to get something popular unless her class let out early. She did try, so I guess I don't have a choice. I'll go in there and get something for you. Just teach her how to shove her way in herself! A girl can't do it! Too delicate and fragile! Which is why I tell her that. Come with me. I'm good at this kind of thing. Just leave it to me. What kind of bread do you want? Of course you can. Does a cutlet sandwich sound good? Legends. They're just sandwiches, you know. So, cutlet sandwich? Does it matter what I think? You just worry about getting one. You want one, right? Okay, I'll be back in a bit. Thank you! I charge towards the crowded bread counter. I force my way through the other students to the front of the display case. But I'm far too late. Of course there wouldn't be any cutlet sandwiches left at this point. I escape the crowded scene, gasping for breath. Sorry, I could only get takoyaki bread. Really? Well, if you say so. Well, here you go.
150 yen.
She takes out a cute wallet and places some coins in my hand. That's when I notice. I forgot to buy something for myself. The strength drains from my body and I hang my head. What am I doing? She asks me as I continue to stand still after taking her money. I haven't bought anything for myself yet. No, it's fine. I'll just wait for the crowd to die down. What? Some kind of bread with toppings on it.
コロッケパンとか焼きそばパンですね。焼きそば?
Yeah!
それでは、行ってきます!
Furukawa goes to stand at the end of the line, leaving me behind. Okay. She doesn't seem to have any intention whatsoever of forcing her way through the scores of people. A wry smile finds its way onto my face. That's fine. I'm okay with anpan. It's fine. I used to eat those things like crazy. Barely ever. I can't remember the last time I had one. But then, of course, I don't like sweets. Oh yeah, they're sweet. That's right. After that, we moved to the courtyard to eat our food. You know, I'm the same way as you. Always late for school. I'm a delinquent. I'm notorious around here for goofing off too much at night and being chronically late for class as a result. I just so happened to not be late today, but I'm pretty sleepy now because of it. I let out a yawn. Yeah, just last night, I didn't get home until 4 in the morning. No. I'm one of those non-smoker hoodlums. Oh man, if you haven't seen the anime, her dad is hilarious. Why doesn't he go outside? That's so inconsiderate. Like, okay, so I have asthma, right? And my parents used to smoke inside. They're both smokers. So I only live with my dad now, and he's still smoking, right? But I remember I was like 15-ish, and 25th of December, like, they'd been smoking like normal, there had been a few people there, and I guess, actually, they'd been smoking a bit more than normal. So 25th of December, I ended up in the hospital because I couldn't breathe because of my asthma. And instead of being like, well, tough luck, my parents, they invested in, like, this, filter cleaner, and they vacuumed the curtains and washed the curtains and opened the windows and stuff. And it took like half a year or something for the smoke smell to be completely gone, and my dad only smokes outside now. So I just kind of feel like if she's ill and she doesn't like the smell of smoke and her dad knows that but still smokes inside, that's just not very safe for her. He should feel ashamed of himself. Oh. Oh my god, that's the worst. Like, it's because my younger brother, he sometimes smokes too. Not as much. And I had a friend that I went to theater with who smoked too, and like, we'd hug goodbye and you can smell the smoke on their clothes. And it's like, yeah, it's fine when it's in your clothes, but like, when you have it on your own clothes, that's just the worst. It feels like it's the first time I've ever seen her smile. I wonder if she's usually smiling like this at home. At least her family cares for her. Her dad would be smoking outside. Smoke outside, Dad! I feel relieved knowing that. Hey, what are you doing after this? Well, you know, after the way the whole drama club thing turned out. Yeah, unfortunately, the club was shut down. I remembered hearing rumors about it after the fact. There was no point in hiding it from her. I let her know just how it was. That's right. It doesn't. It was the last hope she was hanging on to at this place, and now... Yeah, there isn't. You were just unlucky. She seems to have accepted the news much better than I'd expected. Sorry I couldn't get one.
いえ、今のはその、わがまま言ってるわけじゃなく、その、いつか食べられたらいいなということでして。
Now I remember. This is what she does to keep pushing herself forward. Which means that what I just told her must be weighing heavily on her mind. That's no real surprise, though. She doesn't have any friends, and the drama club she wanted to join so badly is no longer around. She peers up at one of the school building's windows. You're right. Nah, we've been here this whole time, haven't we? Try waving at them. Wave your hand at them, and smile while you do it. That might give them something to talk to you about. Yeah, I mean, what do you think would happen if I was to wave? That's a girl up there, you know? Well, it'd look like I was hitting on them if I was the one to wave. Come on, you can do it yourself. I raise her hand for her. Yeah, a big smile. She flaps her hand back and forth through the air with a grin on her face. The figure in the window disappears without warning. Her expression freezes. Sorry about that. She repeats the same excuse over again. Munch, munch. Oh, sorry. The two of us keep our heads affixed to the sky. I wonder if someone will ever come down from the heavens to help her. Furukawa begins to speak. Hearing those words make me happy. I'm not sure if she was even capable of saying something that positive when we first met. Then you should do it. It's easy. No, it's not. It really isn't. I'm talking from experience here. I was part of a... not school drama club, but like a drama... thing. And we just... it is so hard to get members as a new drama thing. It is extremely hard. Yeah. As long as you're dedicated enough, you're... lying.
Definitely.
Yeah, Okazaki, it's easy. Come on, what are you scared of? A pork cutlet bowl.
Hi?
Oh, I was just thinking of how much I like the pork cutlet bowls at the cafeteria, that's all. Anyway, you're the one who ought to be club president. I'm not even interested in place. Be the treasurer, then. You better not tell me you're giving up because of that. Well, the solution to that problem's easy. Just get more club members. She looks worried.
Yeah, it's easy. Just get more members. It's easy. It's so easy. Okazaki, come tell me how easy it is.
Or to be more accurate, she seems to be regretting doing something that she can't take back. I feel a little bit sorry for her.
Help. You...
But you know, I decide to speak up. I won't join the club, but I can at least help you find people who will. Her eyes open wide and she looks at me. Yes. Yeah, I promise. I'll do everything I can to help you out until you become a wonderful club president. Bear in mind, this is her last year. Alright. You're both third years, you're gonna try and start up a club? That really requires members to be able to do anything? Like, I'm not just talking about, it's fine if we're five. It's difficult when you're five. We were just five at my place until we were suddenly just like three left. And it's... No, we were four left. We were four left who were like actively acting. That is really difficult to do in drama because you're so limited. What am I happy about? I just promised to spend a bunch of my time helping out the drama club. At the time of year when everyone's busy cramming for entrance exams. Well, you don't care because you don't want to go to college. Perfect. You wanted a change, now you get it. Stop complaining. No. I'm more like her than them anyway. Ever the bystander. Detached and watching from afar. No. Wouldn't it be great if something like half of the school joined the drama club? Oh, that would be a dream come true. No. Oh! Do you know the productions you can do with that many people? Who are you, girl? Oh well. It's always a good idea to set your sights high. So let's pretend that's our goal. It's not. You want many people in a drama club, trust me. You want as many people as possible. You can do it, Furukawa-san. It's my first time calling her by that name.
Hi.
Once afternoon classes and homeroom end, everyone but the students on cleaning duty leave for the day. What is it, Tsunohara? Tsunohara is sitting on his desk facing me. Yes. Huh?
今日の昼休み、お前の様子変だったし、昨日の帰りも一目散に走って行ったよな。僕も混ぜろって。
Yeah, Tsunohara. Get all of your dorm mates to join. I guess the guys are doing rugby. I don't know what the girls are doing. So go tell the girls to join. And hopefully you won't get beat up by Misai-san. I wish I knew about something that fun. It's nothing. Remember what I told you? A stomach ache or a headache? Both.
マジで?
Yeah, I've been feeling awful.
それだけだったのか?
Hey, thanks for invalidating how bad I feel.
つまんねえの。じゃあ、今日はどっか寄ってこうぜ。
Were you not listening to a word I just said?
Eh?
I'm saying that I feel like shit. Psh! I'm out of here. See ya. I grab my empty bag and make for the door. I'm standing in front of the drama club. Ugh, I'm back here again. Do I really feel that much of a sense of responsibility? Yes, you do. I'm even ignoring my schoolwork, as you always do, so why am I going to these lengths? I hear the pitter-patter of footsteps and turn around. Furukawa is heading in my direction in a half run.
Okazaki-san!
I hear joy in her voice as she says my name. She trots up and stands beside me.
びっくりしました. 誰かいるって思ったら Okazaki-san でした.
Who else would it be? I'm sorry, but we haven't spread the rumors yet. Jeez, sorry to disappoint.
違います. 違う人を期待してたわけじゃないです. Okazaki-san でよかったです. 知ってる人が待ってくれてるなんて思わなかったですから. すごく嬉しくて
I see. While I may be cold and insensitive to her, I'm the one person she can talk to. Well, I open the door. The floor is carpeted with strewn cardboard boxes and equipment. I guess we can start by cleaning. Yep. I carry the stuff into a different empty classroom, then get cleaning supplies from yet another empty classroom before finally getting to work. We dust the place, sweep it with a broom, then wipe it down with cloths. As the setting sun starts to beam into the room, it's finally in good enough shape to use for club activities. I guess this is good enough?
Hi.
Furukawa's eyes gleam as they survey the area.
できました! 私たちの部室です!
Our room? I'm not a club member, you know?
Oh?
Her expression subtly changes. Tears forming along the bottom of her now glassy eyes. But this is one thing I have to make crystal clear. The most I'm gonna do is help you find club members. I don't have any interest in them. Yeah, sorry. I don't. A look of depression washes over her face. I've never even done anything that would have suggested a shred of interest to begin with. Listen, Furukawa?
Hi.
I'll find people in no time. Just leave it to me.
いえ、そういう問題じゃなくて、岡崎さんにいてほしいと思っただけです。何人集まろうとです。
Well, I'm happy you feel that way, but... Well, I'll think about it. How's that? I leave the issue vague.
はい、お願いします.
Yeah, my role here ends with gathering new club members. Once I do that, she'll have lots of people at school to talk to, and then... She definitely won't need to cling to me any longer. That's as far as I'll meddle in her life.